Welcome back. In the last video, we set up our batteries to shoot electricity between themselves and the characters when they were going to be picked up. We're going to do something else visual now and start working towards having a HUD that will display our character's current power as well as the power needed to win the game. This is sort of our building towards having a win state, a lose state, and then sort of the general playing state in the game. So let's switch back. Actually, let's go ahead and close some of these tabs really quick so we've got some room to work with when we come back and start making our HUD. And we will open up our code, go to the game mode. We're going to set up a power to win variable, because if we have a bar to display how much power we need to know what the maximum of that bar would be so that we can win the game. This is also going to be a protected variable. We only want to be able to access it or to be able to change it from within our game mode or classes that derive from it. So power to win. It's a float. It's a U property. And edit defaults only. Actually, it looks like the ones on decay rate will work for that, but let's go ahead and add that metadata to this as well. So blueprint protected. And then we can just copy this whole line because we want those same property flags on power to win as well. And this is obviously the power needed to win the game. Again, this is on the game mode because that's where the rules of the game should go, including how to win the game. We are going to get a public function to return what the power to win is, and that's because that will be needed by the HUD. The HUD is going to be based on a different class, and so for it to know the power to win, it needs to call this function. So we'll have a float called getPowerToWin. It's a constant. It's not going to change anything about the power. It's just going to return it. And it's going to be a U function so that we can call it in our blueprint. But actually, we'll make it a blueprint pure because, again, it's not going to change anything about our power to win. It's just going to tell us what it is. And again, in power category. And we'll just make a note here. Returns power needed to win needed for the HUD. Now we're going to set that in begin play. We can't do it in the constructor because our game mode may not necessarily be constructed after our character is, but we need to base the power to win on the character's initial power. So we're going to do it in begin play because that means everything will already be spawned and registered. So to do that, we need to override begin play here. And this is similar to when we overrode tick before. It's just some functionality it's already provided, but we need to hook into when it is called. So now I can go to the game mode source file, and I'll actually do this here at the top because begin play will happen before tick, but after the constructor. So we've got a battery collector game mode, and begin play. And of course we'll call the parent begin play in case there's anything that happens on the game mode that we need to make sure still gets called. And then we can set the score to beat. We'll do that, like I said, based on the current character's initial power. So to do that, we need to get the gameplay statics, and we already have gameplay statics included, so we can actually get the same line, if you see here below in tick, where we get the character. We could just copy this and use it here. Just like below, we actually need to check that my character exists and was actually the class that we wanted to cast to. There wasn't some other pawn. And if that's true, then power to win is my character's initial power. So use my character, and then you call get initial power multiplied by 1.25. This is another value that we could possibly tweak, and we could even make a variable out of that and have it be set up here in the constructor. But just to test, we're going to multiply and say you need at least 1.25 times your initial power to win the game. So again, we just used the same battery collector cast that we had here below in tick to save on typing. And then if that's true, then we can use that to set power to win. Now we wanted to display that in a HUD, but before we can get started making the HUD, we need to change some of the dependencies in our build file. So you can find the your project's build file here in Explorer. It's right there with the project name, .build.cs. And if you'll notice, you've already got some public dependency module names, and we're just gonna add some things so that we can use UMG here. So we just need to add UMG into this list. And this is true, you know, if you wanted to add any UMG widgets or HUD to your game. So if this is something that's new for you, there's some tutorials online for using UMG with C++. You can definitely go check those out and then come back to the video. And then we're going to add some private dependencies. And it's the same format, so you can sort of follow along with what's right there above. Sometimes templates, depending on your engine version, already had this there commented out saying, well, if you want to use Slate, then uncomment this line. But it's really going to follow the theme or the pattern from above. And we're just going to add Slate and Slate Core, because UMG requires some of these Slate modules. Okay. The other thing here, we need to go to our project header, which is just battery collector.h, and see where it says include engine minimal.h. If you started from a blank project or something that wasn't a template, this is actually just going to say engine.h, and you're going to go ahead and be set to go. Some of the templates have engine minimal set instead of engine, so we're just going to change that really quick to engine.h, and that just means that we will have access to more header files so that this will compile correctly. Finally, we need to go to our back to our game mode and make some variables to hold our widget and then set the widget, and then some code to set the widget. So we'll go to our game mode header, and we need to go to where our protected variables are, and we need a protected variable for the widget and then one for the widget instance. A lot of the formats we're about to use you've seen before, but I'll go through them again. So we have T subclass of that's going to be class user widget. And again, with the forward declaration, because we don't necessarily need to work with the widget yet, so we can just forward declare it like this. And then we've got the class, user widget, current widget. So we've got, this is similar again to that U class, but it's restricted to only things that inherit from user widget. And then this is the specific instance of it that's going to be spawned and created. So let's go ahead and use the same format for the U property for the HUD widget class. So it's edit defaults only. We can only change it on instances. We can do it in the blueprint. We can, and it's protected again, just like the previous variables. For the current widget though, we just want to make it a regular U property so that it's handled correctly with garbage collection, but we're not actually going to manipulate it outside of code, so we don't need any other keywords on it. The widget class to use for our HUD screen, and then this is going to be the actual instance. So this is one copy based on HUD widget class. And that's so once we spawn it in, we can directly interact with current widget, and current widget is just a copy of, IntelliSense is not super happy with me right now. Let's see. Oh, that looks okay. So basically, current widget is one version, one copy based off of the HUD widget class that's there. Oh, okay. IntelliSense is sort of caught up with us a little bit. And finally, we're going to go to our begin play that we just set up. And after we've set power to win, we will set the widget to use. So if our HUD widget class is not null. And this is kind of like when we had the spawn volumes, we said we need to at least make sure that we've set something on that class variable. Then we're going to use widget. So current widget is create widget based off the type user widget. And we're going to get world. And then use that HUD widget class. So that's why we have to make sure that it's not null. If you notice, user widget has got the IntelliSense under it, and we have to go up here and include it. Because now that we're actually making a widget and we have to know what it is, we have to start including it and being able to know more about it. So that's why we need the header file. So I just had to look up the folder that user widget was in. It says in this blueprint/user widget. And then IntelliSense should catch up in just a minute. So now if that's successful, if current widget is not null pointer, then we're going to add it to the viewport. It's really fairly simple to set up a UMG widget, and then we'll go into UMG in the next video, or the UMG UI designer in the next video, and actually lay out our UI with our health bar. So we're just going to hit compile, and then when we come back in the next video, we will set up the HUD and we'll be able to set up the bar showing how much power you need to earn to win the game. Thanks.